Hello guys, welcome back to See Fashion Academy. Today I'll be teaching us a very great topic, which is what bomber jacket, how to cut a bomber jacket. Please, I want you to make sure you watch this video to the end, and also make sure you watch the part 2, how to what sew a bomber jacket. And please, I want you to make sure you click on that like button, make sure you give us a thumbs up if you actually love the video, and make sure you subscribe if you are new to this channel, so that whenever we post a new video, you'll be the first to be notified. Thank you, and may God bless you. Like I said, please make sure you watch this video to the end.
So I'll be teaching us how to make a bomber jacket today. So as you can see, I have my material. So I'll be teaching us how to cut it. Is I assure you that bomber jacket is very simple. But it's one of the simplest dress to make, or jacket to make. It's just the sewing that you need to be very careful with, which is also very simple, but you need to follow due process. So as you can see our material, the first thing you do is what? You fold your material. We all know how we fold our material. Fold it your what? Highest circumference. You can add like extra 5 inches to it. That 5 inches is just for the body allowance, and made probably for the what? Zipper allowance also. Do you understand? That 5 inches can be more than what we actually need, but it is what we need in order to fold. Like, it is okay to use 5 inches. You understand? So fold according to our hair. So in this case, now the measurement we'll be using, the round bust is what? Is the round bust is 38 inches. Do you understand? So now 38 divided by 4 is going to be giving us what? 38 divided by 4. 9.5. Okay. Then 9.5 plus 5, which will be what? 14.5. Do you understand? So that means you fold what? 14.5. And also you fold according to the what? The jacket length. Do you understand? Fold according to the jacket length. Now let's say you measure out your jacket length. Do you understand? Now for the sake of this particular tutorial, our jacket length is going to be 27. Our jacket length is going to be what? 27. Okay, now look at it. When I say our jacket length is going to be 27, you are not just going to measure out 27 and cut. Do you understand? Remember, bomber jacket do have what? Elastic. You understand? So that means you need to subtract the what? Elastic from the what? Total jacket length. Do you understand? So now let's say 27 minus 3. Let's say this particular elastic we are using, the thickness is what? 3 inches. Do you understand? So 27 minus 3 is going to be giving us what? 24. Do you understand? So as you can see, now look at this material. As you can see, we have the front and we have the what? The back. Okay, so let's keep the back aside and measure out the front. We are having the what? This part. All of us know how we got the width, which we folded. Okay, talking about the length, 24. Now look at it. What we have here is not 24, rather what? 25. That is what? 24 plus what? Extra 1 inch. That what? This 1 inch is for the what? The seam allowance, for joining the elastic, and for also joining the what? The shoulder. So now we know how to do what? Fold. Do you understand? And also, I would also like to let you know that the method we'll be using to cut this thing is also the same method I call the what? The together method. That same method, you cut both your what? Front and the back together. Okay. Now, since you folded for the front, as you can see the material for the front, you're also going to fold for the back. Now, all I can tell you to do is what? Fold almost exactly what you folded on the front. But this time around, let the back be what? 2 inches longer than the what? The front. Now look at it. If I say 2 inches longer than the front, whenever you are making bomber jacket, let it be what? 2 inches longer than the front. Now look at it. Yes, I mostly use 3 on senators and other ones. Do you understand? When it comes to jackets, I mostly make use of what? 2 inches. Okay, now look at it. Look at it. If I place both of them together, as you can see, are you seeing it? The back is what? 2 inches longer. Now, so you can see that I'm done folding out the material for both the front and for the back, as you can see. So next thing I'm going to be doing now is what? I'll be drafting the bomber jacket. Is there any question? Okay, no question. So now, in order for us to draft the bomber jacket, first we'll be dealing with is what? As you can see, we'll first be doing what? Slanting our shoulder. We call it what? The shoulder slope. Do you understand? So we're slanting the shoulder. So in order to slant the shoulder, we need the what? Shoulder measurement. In this case, the shoulder measurement is what? 17 inches. Now, 17 inches divided by 2, which we normally divide our shoulder by 2, is what? 8.5. So mark out your 8.5. Are you seeing it? You can as well add extra 1/2 inch allowance to it, making it what? 9. So at this point, we are going to be doing what? Stepping down by what? 2 inches. Do you understand? We are going to be, since it's a bomber jacket, we'll be stepping down by what? 2 inches. Now, I want to let you know that for female, we usually step down with what? From 1 inch to what? 2 inches. Like I said before, why for men is from what? That same 2 inches to what? 3 inches. But for the sake of this particular tutorial, we are making a bomber jacket. Do you understand? We'll be stepping down with what? 2 inches in order to get the what? The shoulder slope. As you can see, are you seeing it? So next thing we'll be doing is what? We'll be taking our rule from here, we'll be connecting in order to get the what? The shoulder slope. As you can see, we've gotten the shoulder slope. So next thing we'll be doing is what? The cutting. Please, I want you to know something. Now look at it. Remember, the back is 2 inches longer than the front. But by me looking at this one now, both of them are equal here. That means that 2 inches extra is showing at the what? The down part. As you can see, it's showing at the what? The down part. So what are we going to do? We are going to place both of them equally here at the upper part. Are you seeing it? So as we'll be cutting out, we'll be cutting both the front and the back. Okay. So next thing I want us to do is what? Please, I want us to do this particular thing. It's either you do it before you do your shoulder slant or shoulder slope, or you can also do it after. It doesn't really matter. So, but I prefer you do it before this shoulder slope. What is that? We should be bringing out what? We'll be bringing out what? The zipper allowance. Do you understand? The allowance for the what? The zipper. Remember, bomber jacket, the zipper allowance is usually what? In front. Do you understand? So that zipper allowance ranges from what? Half inch to what? 1 inch. So we'll be bringing it out. Okay, so as you can see, we folded out what? 1 inch. Are you seeing it? So fold out 1 inch in front. So the next thing we are going to do is what? After folding out this 1 inch, is to do what? Please look at it. Remember, the back is still 2 inches longer than the front. So all you need to do is to do what? Pull this one down. Are you seeing it? Pull it down so that it will be now be what? Equal at the down part, and the excess will be showing at the what? The upper part. And also try to make sure that the both the back and the front, the edges here are what? Equal. Are you seeing it? That is after folding out your what? 1 inch zipper allowance. Okay. So after you are done doing that, please, the next thing you are going to be doing is what? So look at it. Next thing you are going to be doing is what? You are going to be folding out this back so that it will be touching the what? The front part. Please, this is also the same method we use in making what? Shirt. Both men and what? Female shirt. So after you are done ironing it out, and after you are done placing, as you can see, we are now ready to do what? To do the drafting. Okay, so next thing we are going to be doing now, we are going to be marking out the what? The shoulder. So the shoulder, like I said, is what? 17 inches divided by 2, which will be giving us what? 8.5. Add extra half inch seam allowance, which will be what? 9. Okay, so mark out your what? 9 inches. Okay, look at it. Mark out your what? 9 inches. Please also do the same thing here. Are you seeing it? Please, this time around, make sure you are placing it exactly at the edge. Are you seeing it? Make sure you are placing it exactly at the edge. Do the same thing. Mark out your what? 9 inches here. Please, while we are doing this thing, we are doing it in order to get a what? A straight line here. So next thing we are going to be doing now, we are going to be what? Working with our what? Rule. Use your rule and do what? Connect the 2 points. As you can see, we have a straight line here. That means we are about forming the what? The armhole. So in order to form the armhole, we need the what? The armhole length and the what? The armhole base. This forms the what? The armhole. So the armhole length, like I've told us, simply is the what? The same thing we are using here. Do you understand? Since we use 9 here, that is what? Our shoulder divided by 2 plus half inch. Please use exactly the same thing here. This is a very simple method. There are also different methods you use to get the what? Armhole length, but this one is the simplest. Okay, so we are be marking out what? 9. But there's something I still want to tell us. Since we are making a bomber jacket, if you like, you can also extend it with like extra half inch allowance. Do you understand? So as for it to be more free. Do you understand? Since it's a what? A bomber jacket. A bomber jacket is not supposed to be tight for any reason. Do you understand? Okay. So now we have 9. We have our... Okay, as you can see, this is what? The armhole length, and this is what? The armhole base. Okay. So now these two forms the what? The armhole. So next thing that is remaining is for us to form our what? Armhole curve. Do you understand? So in order for you to form your armhole, like I've just done it now, we also have an official method which you can form it by doing what? Placing your tape here. Are you seeing it? Diagonally, place your tape diagonally like this and mark out what? 1 inch. So at this point of 1 inch, that is where you are going to connect your curve. Also, I would also like you to know that where you'll be coming from here is the what? The middle part of your what? Armhole length. Look at it. From here to here is what? 9 inch. And from here is what? 4.5. Are you seeing it? So from this 4.5, from here, you'll be connecting down touching the what? 1 inch you marked diagonally, then like this. So at the end of the day, you've gotten your what? Armhole curve. Do you understand? So now, like I said, there is also another one we call the what? The armhole effect. Do you understand? We usually add it so that our dresses, our clothes will not be so folded or rumpled at the what? Around the what? Armhole region. Do you understand? But I want to let you know something. Since you are making a bomber jacket, it's so free. It's a free dress. Do you understand? So it is not mandatory for you to apply the what? The armhole effect on a bomber jacket. Do you understand? Since it's not fitted, we don't need fitting in any way. Do you understand? So it is not mandatory. So for the sake of this particular tutorial, I'm going to do what? Neglect it. Do you understand? I'm not going to affect it here. Okay. So next thing you're also going to do is to do what? Please, I want us to know, whenever we are working on this bomber jacket, please, I want us to know that our chest point or our bust point is no longer the normal bust point. Do you understand? Just take this what? The from here to here, you seeing it? This is your armhole, where the armhole stops. Take it as your what? The bust point. Do you understand? Take it as the what? The chest point. Okay. So now, the round bust or your chest point, for either for male or for female. Do you understand? The round bust is what? Or the round chest is what? 38 inches. That is 38 divided by 4 is what? 9.5. So place your what? Mark out your what? 9.5. Is I want you to also do what? Add your extra what? 2 inches allowance. Is I want you to know that this measurement that I'm using is the measurement that I call what? The fitted measurement. It is the measurement that when you measure the person, you don't add excess allowance on the person's body. Do you understand? You don't see the fitting as you want it. You just have to do what? Directly measure the tight measurement of the person. That is why I'm adding these 2 inches extra. Do you understand? But if you are to measure the person and add all the allowances on the body of the person, you don't need to do what? Add these 2 extra inches allowance. You can add maybe whatever you are using to sew. If it is half you want to use to sew, put it there. If it is one, do you understand? You put it there. Hope you understand this one. Okay. So please, I want you to know that the same thing you did here is the same thing you are going to do from here. Now, I know some of us will be asking me, at which point is this? It is at no point. Just any point. I just want to draw a straight line from this particular point. Do you understand? Okay, so let me mark out the same chest round bust, which is what? 9.5 plus what? 2 inches. Okay. So now that I've gotten these 2 points, it will now help me to do what? To get a straight line. Now the question is, why are we having a straight line? Why are we having a straight line like this? Why is there no shape? Like I told us initially when I was explaining this bomber jacket, it has no specific shape. It doesn't, like, you don't draft it with your what? Body measurement. The only thing that we use there is our what? Our bust, and we added extra what? 2 inches allowance. Do you understand? So at the end of the day, I can be able to tell you that we are 95% done with this bomber jacket. The only thing remaining is the what? The round neck. Do you understand? Okay. Okay. So like I said, guys, the next thing remaining is to do what? To mark out the neck. So in order for us to mark out the neck, it's still the same thing. We need what we call the what? The neck block. The neck block consists of the what? The neck width and the what? The neck depth. So the neck width, like I've told us, is just the distance between the, like, the width of the wideness of your neck. Do you understand? Now, for the sake of this particular tutorial, we'll be making use of what? 2.5, which when you expand the clothes, it will be what? 5 inches. Do you understand? Okay, so 2.5. From here, mark out what? 2.5. Please, I want to let you know something. If you are making a hood bomber jacket, you can as well not use 2.5, you can use what? 3 inches. Do you understand? Because school jacket really needs the neck to be wider. Do you understand? Okay, please take this point. So let me mark out 2.5. So at the end of the day, I've gotten the what? The neck width. So use your rule and do what? To connect. So what is meaning now is the what? The neck depth. Do you understand? So now, like I've told us, since it's a bomber jacket, and you know that if we are putting elastic on the neck, that means it actually still works with our round neck. Do you understand? So the same way you handle your shirt is almost the same way you do or work on this one. Do you understand? But please, I want us to know that instead of it being so tight, it's better it's kind of what? Loose, but not excessively loose. Do you understand? So what I'll be using here now is what? Now, please, I want you to see this thing now. What I'll be using here now is what? From 4.5 to what? 5 inches. Okay, let me just say from 4 inches to what? 5 inches. Do you understand? If you use 4 inches, it is okay. Please, I still want you to do something. when you finish cutting or when you finish coupling, before you put your what elastic, please make sure you check the what, the circumference of the what, the neck. It is very, very important. It is not, if it is not up to what you want, you need to do what? Trim it more. Because the neck is the last thing. Do you understand? The elastic on the neck is the last thing we do on this particular dress. So remember what I told us, you can start from what? Okay, let me say you can start, like I said, you can start from what, 4 inches to what, 5 inches. Does not mean you can't go beyond 4 inches, like 3.5. It depends on the what, the circumference of your neck. Okay, for the sake of this particular tutorial, I'll be making use of what? I'll be making use of 5 inches. I'll be making use of 5 inches. Now look at it. I'm measuring out what? 5 inches. Now as you can see, I've gotten the what? The neck. This is what is called the neck block. Are you seeing? It's a block. So I'll be using it to do what? Construct the what? The neck. So in order to construct the neck, the same thing I did here in order to get the curve, are you seeing it? Is exactly the same thing I did. Please, I want to let you know that anytime you want to get a curve, use this similar method to get it. Do you understand? So at this point whereby the horizontal and the vertical line is joining, that is where you mark out what? 1 inch. Are you seeing it? Diagonally, mark out what? 1 inch. Now, are you still seeing it? At the middle of this one and this one, are you seeing it? From there, you do what? Connect your what? Curve. So this is how we get the what, the round neck. Now there's still something else remaining. We are not done yet. Look very well around this part. You cannot just leave it like this. Do you understand? We still need to do what, curve it the same way. Are you seeing it? But now since we used one here, you can as well use what, quarter or what, half inch around this particular point. What do I mean by quarter or half inch? Look at it. The same way we diagonally marked here. Are you seeing it? One. The same way you also diagonally marked here. Are you seeing it? Measure out what, quarter or what, half inch. As you can see, what I actually use there is what, half inch. Okay. So this is how you mark out your what, neck. So next thing you are going to be doing is what, you are going to be cutting it out. Do you understand? Okay. So let's cut it out. Is why cutting it out, make sure you don't cut the two. Do you understand? Make sure you don't cut the two. Some of us make mistake cutting the two. You've actually spoiled your material. Make sure you lift this one up, only the front. Are you seeing the cutting from here? So immediately you get to this point, you start from the what? The back. Are you seeing it? Okay. So now you can as well expand this one. Are you seeing it? Now use your chalk and there. Do like this. Are you seeing it? Now what did I actually do here? Now look at where this one is coming. Are you seeing it? So from here, see what I'm saying at this point. So from that same point, you can step down with what, half inch or what, 3/4 inch. Do you understand? So from there, mark out this thing and do what, cut it off. As you can see, are you looking at it? So we are done with this particular one. So next thing we are going to be doing is what, we are going to be cutting it out. Okay, so in order to cut it out, let's cut it out. Remember I told us that a bomber jacket does not really have shape. It is the what? Elastic band that gives it this what? Shape. Since there is no armhole effect, to be cutting both the front and the back armhole together. Please, you can as well add your armhole effect, though. It just depends on you. But like I say, because of it's a bomber jacket, it is not what? Mandatory. Okay, next thing is what? As you can see the front that we folded, we are going to do what? Open it. Okay, so as you can see, this is just a bomber jacket. Do you understand? It's as simple as that. This is how to cut it. So is there anyone here that can say that this is not the simplest that he or she have seen? Like seriously, that's the simplest. There's nothing else here. So the major thing here is what, the sewing part. Do you understand? You have to be very careful. You have to follow the due procedure while sewing it. Okay, after we are done cutting out the normal body of the jacket, which is very simple, next thing we are going to be doing is what, we're going to be cutting out the what, the pocket. So in order to cut out the pocket, as you can see, this is the kind of pocket I want to put on this particular dress. Do you understand? This is the kind of pocket. So in order for us to put this pocket, we need a piece of speech wheel. Please, I want you to know that you can use any kind of pocket on your what, bomber jacket. You can use a wet pocket. You can use, this one is the most common that people normally use. So that's what I'm actually teaching this one today. So in order to, for you, as you can see, look at it. Look at the shape. Are you seeing it? So in order for you to cut out this pocket, all you need to do is to do what? First of all, cut out your pieces. Do you understand? Now, this is your pieces now. There are so many measurements or many details you need to know about cutting out these pieces. First of all, let's say our pocket usually starts from where? Around the what? The waist region. Do you understand? Around the world, the waist. That's where the pocket usually starts from. So looking at this one, you see that it is around the waist. Are you seeing a 15 and a half, almost 16? Are you seeing it? So check out your own. That is where it starts from. Okay, then next is what? Now, see what I want you to do. When you measure around your waist, are you seeing what? Whatever it is, let's say it is 15, it is 16. Measure out the rest. Are you seeing? Separately measure out the rest. That is what? This part of the world, the pieces you're supposed to cut. Are you seeing it? That is the length of the pieces. Hope you understand this thing. In order to know the length of the pieces you cut out, measure out your what? Your waistline, where your pocket is supposed to start. So now the remaining one is the what? Your waist, this measurement of these pieces. Then talking about the width of the pocket, do you understand? The pieces you are going to cut out. The width is exactly what you have here. Please, add in the what? The zipper allowance. Remember what I said? Remember there is this zipper allowance. Adding the zipper allowance, measure out. Are you seeing what do we have here? Is what 12 and a half? That means exactly what 12 and a half. Hope this one is clear. That is it. So now look at it here, from here to here. Now is what 9 and a half. Then the pieces from here to here is what 12 and a half. Hope we've all gotten how I got this particular pieces, the shape. So after you finish cutting out these pieces, next thing you need to do, look at it. First of all, place it on top of your what, the front part of your dress. Are you seeing it? Please. These pieces, I want you to know that, as you can see, you're only seeing two pieces here. Are you seeing it? Remember, this is for the world, both the left and the world, the right. Do you understand? But it is not just like that. See, you have to cut it what, four times. Not just these two. Let's say after you finish cutting these two, use it and cut extra two again. Then what is the reason why we are cutting extra two? Now look at it. Looking at this pocket, in order to get a better finishing, look at the back. Are you seeing it? There is no folding. Do you understand? That means we have what? Two. Are you seeing it? Two materials. Are you seeing it? Two. So that is why I'm saying we need to cut out another one. But I'm just showing us this one so as for you to know how to cut out the normal template. Okay. So look at it. So the next thing is what? In order to form the pocket shape where you're going to be putting your hand. You understand? So I have this standard I usually give. From here to here, we use what? 5 inches or what? 6 inches. Are you seeing it? From here to here, use what? 5 inches or 6 inches. But for the sake of this particular tutorial, I'm going to be using what? 5 inches. Now look at it. Are you seeing it? Then next you are going to be doing, when you mark 5 inches here, from here also, mark out what? 5 inches. Do you understand? Okay. Now look at what I said. From here to this point, mark out 5 inches, 6 inches, depending on how wide you want the opening of your pocket to be. Here it is not fixed. Do you understand? Then from here is what? The same thing you use here is the same thing you use here. Do you understand? But don't mistakenly use the same thing in a way that at the end of the day, there will be nothing really remaining here in order to form the pocket. So look at it here. I have my 5 inches here. Are you seeing it? And I also have my what? 5 inches here. Hope you can see it. So next thing I'll be doing is what? I'll be connecting with any kind of curve you want. If you need a straight curve, you want your pocket to have this shape, no problem. If you want your own to have this shape, are you seeing this one? No problem. Just any kind of shape. If you want it to have this shape, block like this, it is your pocket. Do you understand? So any kind of shape you want your own to have. So next thing you need to do is to do what? Take your scissors and then cut it out. So as you can see, we've actually formed the what? The pocket. Are you seeing it? So when I unpin it, this is how the pocket is supposed to be on this particular dress. Now look at it. Please be very, very careful. If not, you will even make mistake while placing it, because this pocket can change its position on its own. Now look at it. Are you seeing it? From here to here and from here to here. Are you seeing it? So that is just, are you seeing now? This one is only one. So that's why I say you need to cut two in order to turn it with. You understand? Another one to turn this one so as to get a neat finish. So that is how to cut the pocket. So now we're moving over to what? Please, I want you to know that exactly the same way you cut your fabric here is the same way you're going to cut your what? Lining. Please, I want you to know just exactly the same way you're going to cut your lining. Please, you can also make use of another material to cut your lining if you need a what? A two-faced bomber jacket. What do I mean by a two-faced bomber jacket? Bomber jacket that you can wear both the front and you can wear both the what? The back. Do you understand? So whichever one you want to do is in your hands, you can actually do what. So I'll be showing us how to cut the sleeve, which already I know that all of us here know how to cut the sleeve. But I will also do that. So in order to cut a sleeve, you need to fold your material. Do you understand? The slave is usually paid in pair. Do you understand? To the left and the right, or right and left. Okay. So when you fold your material, but you fold your material considering the what? Your armhole length plus what? Let's say extra 2 to 3 inches, which in this case our armhole length is what? 9, which is same thing as our shoulder divided into 2. Do you understand? So 9 plus what? Extra 2 is what? 11, 12. Do you understand? So that means you fold nothing less than what? 12 inches, which as you can see, what we have here is more than what? 12 inches, which is what? Okay. So also, you also fold according to your what? The length of your what? Sleeve. Please always know that. So considering the length of our sleeve, the same thing we did on the what? Bomber jacket. The same thing we are doing here. What is it? Okay, now look at it. The bomber jacket sleeve length is what? 20. Bomber jacket sleeve length is 24 inches. Do you understand? So now you subtract your elastic band, which is what? 3 inches. Do you understand? You subtract it from the what? 24, which will be getting what? 21 inches. So now that 21, you add extra what? 1 to it. Do you understand? For what? Seam allowance, which is what? 22. So as you can see, what we have here is what? 22 inches. Okay, now we are done folding. Remember what I said? We'll be working with the what? The armhole length and the what? The armhole base. Okay, so for those of us that don't know what is armhole length and armhole base, now look at it. Armhole length is the distance from here, are you seeing it, to here, which what we have already is what? 9 inches. Why the armhole base is the distance, are you seeing it, from here to here, are you seeing it? So what do we have here is what? 3 inches. Okay, this is what we'll be working with in order to get your what? Sleeve perfectly, so that when you sew it, it will totally rhyme exactly without one becoming, without one being more than the other one. Do you understand? Okay. So now, the armhole length we have is what? 9 inches. Do you understand? So mark out what? 9 inches to it. Remember what I said? You should mark out what? You should add extra what? 2 inches to it. Do you understand? So at this particular point, this is where you are going to be computing your what? Armhole base. Let me still say it again. Armhole base is distance from here to this particular place, which what we have is what? 3 inches. Okay, are you seeing it at this point? So next thing we'll be doing is what? We'll be connecting this to this point, just the same way I'm marking it up. Are you seeing it? Connect it like this in order to form your what? The curve here. Are you seeing it? Now for those of us that don't see, you can actually connect it like this if you can follow like the same way I just did it here. Do you understand? But if you really want to know the exact what I did here, you understand? So what I did here, see what I just did here. From here to here, which is this 9 inches, are you seeing? Divided by 2, which what you are going to be getting is what? 4.5. So at this particular 4.5, are you seeing it? Step down by what? Half, which you can see is exactly the same thing I marked. Are you seeing it? Step down by half, which is at this particular point. Are you seeing it? So that means you connect from this point to this point, then gradually extend it to the middle part of this point. Are you seeing it? So that is how to do what? Construct the sleeve. Okay, now we are done with this. Next thing remaining is the what? The elbow length. We are going to be marking the elbow. Now the elbow length is what? 12 inches. Are you seeing it? So at this particular point, 12 inches, we impute the what? The round elbow, which is also what? 12 inches, which is what? 6 inches. Please, you add your extra what to it? 2 inches allowance. You can add 1.5 to what? 2 inches allowance, since it's a bomber jacket. Okay. So please, I also for I skipped the word the bicep. Most of us don't put the bicep, but even if you don't have your bicep measurement, you can as well skip it. Do you understand? It's not that too mandatory. Do you understand? You can skip it and continue like this. Okay, but let me say you have your bicep measurement. Let's say the bicep I'll be using for this one is what? 14 inches. Do you understand? So now some of us will be asking, at which point is this? Please, normally standard bicep from here is like 5 inches. Do you understand? So from this 5 inches, let me put my 14 inches, which is what? 14 divided by 2 is what? 7. You add your extra what to it? 2 inches. Do you understand? So now the same thing you do to your what? The sleeve length. So now see, we have this point. Are you seeing it? We have this point. So now going to the sleeve length, please look at it. Sleeve length, this is the end part. So we are going to be imputing the what? The round sleeve. Now, how exactly do we get the round sleeve? Please, I want you to know something. You get the round sleeve, look at it, by measuring your what? Wrist. Now in this case, you don't measure the actual wrist. Do you understand? You pull it up. Do you understand? From here, that is where you measure. Most of us make mistake, we measure the exact wrist. No, you don't measure it exactly. You pull it up like this. Are you seeing it? Then you measure out here. Are you seeing it? You pull it up and you measure out here. So what I have here now on her own is what? 9 1/2. Do you understand? So this 9 1/2 divided by 2, place it here and also add your what? Your seam allowance. Do you understand? Okay. But for the sake of this particular tutorial, what I have here is what? The same, what I'll be using here is what? 9 inches. Do you understand? That is 4 1/2. And I add my extra what? 2 inches allowance. As you can see, I've gotten all the points to form my what? Sleeve. So in order to form my sleeve, so from here, I'll connect to this particular point. Are you seeing it? Then connect to this particular point. Then finally to this particular point. So now what I want to tell us is that if you follow this process to cut your sleeve, there is no way your sleeve one will be longer than the other. And there is no way you wear the dress and people and you complain of like, or your customer will complain of excess allowance around the what, the bicep region. No, everything will just go accordingly. Do you understand? So after you are done doing that, next thing you'll be doing is what? Take your scissors and then cut it off. Please, I want you to know that the same way you've cut your sleeve, even on the jacket, exactly the same way you've cut your material, it's the exact way you are still going to cut your what? Your lining. Please, I want you to know that exactly the same way. So now we are done cutting out this one. Like I told you guys, it's not that too necessary for not to add what? Armhole effect. Do you understand? So I can as well leave this one like this. So next thing I need to do is to do what? I need to notch the what? The center part. You can as well notch this part, which is not compulsory, but you can do that so as to make the work simpler for you. Okay, so I am done cutting the sleeve. As you can see, so simple.
Okay guys, as you can see, we are done cutting. So please make sure you watch the next video on how to sew the bomber jacket. That is a very, very important video. Make sure you watch it, because cutting this bomber jacket is very simple. It is the sewing that you need to pay more attention to, which is not really hard, but you really need to pay attention. So that's why you need to watch this particular video. Okay, and also make sure you click on that like button. Make sure you give us a thumbs up if you actually love this video. And if you are new to this channel, if you are new to this channel, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you click on that red subscription button. It is free of charge. You click on that red subscription button so that whenever we post a new video, you'll be the first to be notified. And make sure you click on that bell icon. Thank you, and may God bless you. See you next time.